day two.
Gonna try and get these trees, won't get the whole lot done today, but I certainly want to get the majority of that done.
It's gonna be a long day.
Let's see how we do. Working in here, did a little bit of work yesterday before I finished. Just gone over that with a little bit of liquid. It's because I find that when the paint dries, it goes matte, and the liquid sort of pulls out the colour again. So just give that a little coat, and I'm just going to fill in those slightly darker areas. So a little bit of liquid and a little bit of white spirit. Touch of that white. Just want it quite dark. Shadow under it. Yeah, even darker. That will do. Now in the photograph, there's obviously you have this line of trees here, but right in front of that, sitting on this bank here, is another tree. But that's, as I say, it's sitting this side, so I won't do that, I won't put that in yet. I'll put that in once that background is completed. So now I'm just going to continue with this area. Too dark on that. Dark area just under this tree here, and then another one just up here. Something like that. Maybe another area there. So I'm going to work on this area here first, before I move on to that. I just want to show you how I'm going to do this bit here, and then I'll do some of this area afterwards, and I'll probably speed that up a bit. But I just want to give you some detail on this part here. So I've put the darker areas in, and mainly I used liquid, the French ultramarine blue here, ivory black, touch of sap green. I used a little bit of lemon yellow and just a dab of titanium white. It's almost just been dry brushed on. Okay, so now I'm going to do those lighter canopies over the top. Okay, so let's start mixing. So I've gone for a whole load of the lemon yellow, or Windsor lemon, I think it's called. Windsor lemon, cerulean blue, on top of the colour that I'd already mixed, a little bit of white, a little bit of burnt umber. We're just going to keep adding until we get the colour as near as possible. So that's not a million miles out, let's have a look. Yeah, it's not too bad. I can't really see, because it is this area is sitting behind a tree, I can't really see, you know, exactly what is there. So I can see roughly, but I'm just having to pretty much make it up. But it won't matter too much, because by the time I paint the tree over the top, it won't really matter. So the consistency of this is, it's fairly, as you can see, it's fairly watery, but not so watery that you lose some of the colour. I'm just going to continue to build up under here, bearing in mind that this is the first layer, so as we go on we'll add other variations of colour and things like that. So we've finished this area now. There's not any real detail in there. I mean, there's in the photograph there would be more variation in colour, but that tree is going to cover that, so that should be fine. So I'm going to leave that as it is now, and then I'm going to move over to this area here. Same technique, same brush, just putting the darker areas in, and then the canvas over the top. Burnt umber, ultramarine. Thank you. as we did before, put in the darker areas. Now I'm just going to put in the lighter canopies over the top. But this time, because we're not painting behind a tree, I'm going to put in more variation and a little bit more detail. Another technique I'm going to use, just to go over some of the areas that I've already done and to make it a little bit less regular, is to, it's the same, well, same sort of technique with a different brush. Pop it on. Slightly thicker as well, the paint for this. So it's a technique I've shown you in the past, but one that is good for this. I've just thickened up on the paint a little bit, so now I'm using the palette knife as a place to mix the paint as a palette. So it just makes it that little bit quicker. Not having to mix over on the palette board. Here we go.